Welcome to PC Mac. Today in this video we are going to install Nginx server with MySQL and phpMyAdmin on Openmediavault. So let's do it. Before we start, I would like you to go ahead and click on the subscribe button. It's free and you can just go ahead and click on the bell icon for my latest videos. So let's get started. First of all, I'm going to open the wireless network watcher to check the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. The Openmediavault, the address is 192.168.1.78. Let me go ahead and close it. I'm using a fresh copy of Openmediavault for this project. So let me just go ahead and open Google Chrome. Let me just maximize it and open the 78 IP. Now let me log in with the default password. So first thing first, we'll change the password. Now let me quickly configure the date and time. So the date and time configured successfully, time zone is configured successfully. Let's go ahead and go into update management and click on check. Let's turn on the SSH because we are not able to update our program from here. So the SSH is enabled. Now we'll go ahead and log in from here. We need to click on apply. Yes. We log in with root with the default password Openmediavault. We need to change the password. Now we'll type the first command, sudo apt-get update. Let me minimize this. So once the update and upgrade process complete, we will go ahead and open our Google Chrome and check into update management if there is any update available or not. So there is no new package now available. What we'll go and do is go into plugin and then select the plugins that we need to install, that is Nginx and then MySQL, and install both of them. As you can see, now both the packages are installed successfully. We need to click on close to reload the page and OK. Now the page will reload and as you can see, MySQL is right here and Nginx server is right here. Now we'll go ahead and configure our Openmediavault for Nginx. So what we need to do, first of all go to general settings, then we need to change the port number. Let's select a port 90. Why we are doing this? Because Nginx default port is 80, so that's why we are changing the port for Openmediavault. Let's go ahead and click on save, apply. Yes. Now to open the Openmediavault, we just need to put colon, then the port number 90 and hit enter, leave, and we can easily access our page for Openmediavault. Now the first step is done. The second step is to create the physical disk. Let's select this one, wipe it out. Yes, quick. It's finished, close. In the next step, we'll go to file system and create a file system with the disk. And let's label it as store. Okay. So it's also done. Click on close, click here, and let's just finish the initialization and then mount. Now the device is mount, the disk is mount. We need to click on apply and yes. Then we need to go to user and create a user. Let me create a user with my name, PC Mac. Let's put a password and make it a member of admin group and save. Let's save now. Click on apply. Yes. Now we'll go ahead and create a shared folder. Add. The name of the folder will be www. The device will be store. Leave the other settings as it is. Click on save. The folder is created now. Let's go to privileges and provide the user read and write privilege, and then ACL. Provide PC Mac admin, and to access the website we need to select www data, user and groups, apply, close, apply, yes. So the shared folder path is done. We'll go to FTP now, enable it, save, apply, yes. Now we'll go to share, add, select the folder which we created, www, save. It's saved now. We need to apply. Now let's first of all configure Samba, then share, add, select the folder, www, save, and apply, yes. So this part is done. First of all, we'll go and configure the Nginx website. To do that, first of all, we need to go into pools, then add. Let's select a folder like with the name PHP, phpMyAdmin. We need to select the folders, user www and the group www. Leave the settings as it is. Click on save. It's created now. Then apply. Yes. Okay. Go to server. Add. Select the folder www. Root directory. Just turn it off for a moment. Leave the other settings as it is. Enable PHP and select the folder which we created in pools, and enable PHP and then save. So it's saved now. We go to settings, enable it. First of all, apply, yes. Then save the settings again. Apply, yes. Now we'll go to servers and check whether the Nginx is up or not. So Nginx is up now. Let me close this box and go to MySQL, enable it and enable site management from here. So we can use this option. And once it's done, we'll save it. Wait for apply. Apply, yes. Then reset the password for the database. Click on save. Now we can use this option to show our database. So the default user ID is root and the password is we just created and login. You can see we are logged into our database MySQL. Let's go back to OpenMediavault and everything is done from here. We just need to put some files into the shared folder and check whether our Nginx server able to access those files or not. So let me go ahead and do that. First of all, we need to access our default path, that is the URL 78. Once we click OK, it will take us to the folder, the shared folder which we created with the name www. It will be appear in a moment. Yeah, it's right. Let's go ahead and put some files on this folder. Let's first of all try with the HTML website. So instead of PHP, we'll try to put HTML and check. Right now, Nginx is not pointing to the www folder. We'll check that later on why it's not doing that. Let me just close it. Close this one as well. So our Nginx server is installed. MySQL server is installed. Now we will go ahead and install phpMyAdmin. To do that, we need to type a command sudo apt install phpMyAdmin. So we have already created our MySQL database. So we hit enter to yes. Now we need to put the password which we created for MySQL and OK one more time and one more time for the confirmation. Now it gave us two options, Apache 2 and Light TPD, but we already installed our Nginx server, so we don't need any of these. So we'll press the tab button and hit OK to install the phpMyAdmin. Now the PHP is successfully installed in our computer in Raspberry Pi OpenMediavault. So it's done. We'll go ahead and check whether we are able to access PHP or not. So we need to type phpMyAdmin. So right now it says 404 not found. This is because there is no connection between the Nginx server and phpMyAdmin. So to establish the connection between PHP and Nginx server, what we need to do, we need to type a command here. So the command is, I'm pasting right here. So it create a link between user share phpMyAdmin and user share nginx.nginx/html. So once this connection is established, the Nginx server can talk to phpMyAdmin. Now what we need to do is run some commands. We will restart the PHP and we will restart the Nginx server. So all the changes successfully configure on our Nginx server. Now once this done, we will restart our machine. Sudo reboot now. So now the server is restarting. Once it's restart, then we will check whether our Nginx server, phpMyAdmin and MySQL is working or not. So we'll go ahead and log in. First of all, we'll check the Nginx is working or not. We'll go to server and then open. So Nginx is working. Let's check that index.html is working or not. So it's pointing to Nginx website. Let's check that MySQL is working or not. So it's also working. Let's try root. Now we'll check that our phpMyAdmin is working or not. So as you can see, phpMyAdmin is also working. Let me just log in with root. And it's working fine. It's connected to MySQL. And it's working, as you can see. Now we will check. We will try to open a PHP website as well. Let's try to put a PHP website and check whether the PHP website is working or not. So here is a PHP website. Now let's try to access the file again. And as you can see, it's working. I put a vtiger CRM file on the server and it's working fine now. You can go ahead and install it and check. You need to check the versions and everything to install vtiger CRM on OpenMediavault and use it. Let me go ahead and close these windows. So guys, that's it from my end. If you like my video, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. If you have any questions, you can write down in the comment section. I try to answer them. So thank you for watching my video, guys. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.